Hi, welcome. This is Clemens at Elektor. In this video, we will have a look at the new Arduino IDE 2.0 beta.3. A few days ago, I received a press release from Arduino telling me that they had released the Arduino IDE 2.0, a beta version, and so I downloaded it to give it a try. On the download page, it says that it is almost complete, but that there may be minor issues. I haven't looked at it at all, so for me too, this is a first try. It looks a lot like the Arduino Pro IDE that they launched some months ago, but there is no button here to switch between Pro and Normal mode. However, on the website it is mentioned on the Pro page. After launching it, it opens with the dimmer sketch. You have to select a board, so let's choose a board. I will use an Arduino Uno. I have no board connected, so it doesn't discover it automatically. Let's connect the board first. Here we go. It found the board on COM4. Okay. Right, now you have to install the core. Yes. So this is probably going to take a while. Let's be patient. I do not have a very fast connection, but the files are coming in. Apparently we have AVR GCC 7.3.0. Ah, the boards manager found the boards package for the Arduino AVR boards. The IDE 2.0 download is already some 200 megabytes. It's over 600 megabytes after installation. Add to that the toolchain of 400 megabytes or so, so you will need at least 1 gigabyte of disk space. Let's have a look at this button here, clear output. Okay, well, we will not do that. We can have a look at the IDE while it's downloading. The menu looks the same as in version 1. Same menu, file, edit, sketch, tools and help. There's a debug button here, but as it says here, debugging is not supported by Arduino Uno. Save, upload, and new. Again, debug. Here we have the boards manager, which is now open, and the library manager. Okay, close the boards manager, open the library manager. There is no progress indicator, so I have no idea how long this is going to take. Here we have a settings button, opens preferences. Oh, there are many settings. Still downloading apparently. I have no idea how much is left to download. Nice improvement for the future, add a progress indicator. Close the settings. File menu. Okay, so it finds my old sketchbook. Here are the examples. All in all, the interface looks much cleaner and much nicer. Here we have again preferences. Now these are different preferences. So there are two preference settings for the IDE. One like you had in the IDE version 1 and a lot of other settings. Okay. In the edit menu, copy for GitHub, copy for forum. Looks a lot like the previous IDE. Optimize for debugging is of course new. Library manager, which opens on the side. Tools menu. Ah, the serial plotter has disappeared. So this all looks pretty much the same as in IDE version 1. Here we have developer tools. Okay, this is some sort of HTML editor. This is probably for IDE development, at least I wouldn't know what to do with it. Let's close this. Now it would be nice if we could compile this now to see if it works. Maybe the download is completed, I don't know, let's try. Okay, apparently this works. Done uploading, but it's still working. Upload complete. Nothing happens on the board, but that's probably because you must connect a potentiometer or so. Let's try another example. My favorite, a blink without delay. Upload. Oh, error unknown. I have to reselect my board. Does this mean that you can have several boards connected at the same time? Now my LED is blinking, so this works. So basically we have a new IDE that looks a lot like the previous IDE. Let's open another example. Again, you must select a board, which is a bit annoying if you want to try out several examples. Let's upload this sketch to the board. Uploading error. Why? You try again. Again, upload error. Reset the board and try again. Alright, what am I doing wrong? Let's try a new sketch that I write myself. Autocomplete. No autocomplete. Oh, I don't like this. Bad indentation. Okay, here we go. Select the board. Again, and upload error. Disconnect the board and reconnect it again. Still upload error. Okay, the IDE stopped working apparently, don't know why. I will stop now. Summarizing, we can say that the new IDE version 2.0 looks nicer than version 1 and probably has interesting new features, but for now Arduino Uno users are probably better off sticking to IDE version 1. As I said at the beginning, minor issues are to be expected with this new IDE and I quickly ran into a few. I will wait until they are resolved before switching to the new IDE. Okay, that's it. I hope you found it interesting. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click or tap the bell button. Thank you for watching.